Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In this video, we will see one of the most important interview question which I have faced in Java. That is like how to reverse an array list of elements. So there are certain elements in the array list and you have to reverse the array list. So we'll see different approaches to that and we'll see a practical example for that. So before we get started, if you are new to my channel, subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon. So let's get started. I'll create a Java class for the demonstration. We'll give the name reverse elements. And then we'll take the main method and we'll open finish. If we reverse an array list, we will create an array list and we'll add elements to that. For that, I'll take a list and then I'll give the element types to be integer and I'll create the array list. I'll write array list and then I'll close this statement. So we'll import list and as well as array list. Now we'll give the type here. Okay, let's add the element. To add the element to the list, we'll do list variable dot add of some value. So I'm adding 100 here. Now let's copy paste so that we can add multiple values to the list. So we have added 100. We'll add 200. 300, 400, 500, 600, and 700. So now let's print this array list and we'll see how to do that. So generally for printing the array list, what we'll do, we'll iterate to the array list and using the for each or for, we'll print the values. Now I'll show you a different approach here. In Java 8, we have something called lambda expression. Using that, you can do that. So what we'll do, we'll take list name dot for each and then we'll give the lambda expression. So I'm taking the x variable and I'm printing this value of x. So if you do that, it will take each and every element, it will iterate to the list and it will print. So if we execute this, we will see that we have got all the elements printed on the screen. Now let's reverse this. So in order to reverse your list, there are multiple approaches for that. First is that you can convert your array list to the array and then you can iterate in the reverse order and then add those elements to the array list. That is the first approach. Second approach is that you can take a new array list, you can loop to the first array list in the reverse order and then add each element to the new array list. And once the new, all the elements have been copied to a new array list, again you can copy the new array list to the old array list. Okay, and the another approach which I have given to the interview is that in generally what we'll do, whenever we want to reverse anything, array or array list, we try to find the method in that class. So let's try to do that if you have any methods as like that. So we have let's try to search it R. We have remove, remove all, remove if, replace, iterate. Okay, we see that only remove methods are there. We don't see anything called as reverse. So the main thing which you need to remember is that there is a class called collections here. And it provides a lot of methods for us to use. Like we can say that binary search is there. We have other methods, copy is there, and then you have a lot of methods. You have something called index of sublist, you have max min function, and then so in that way we have a function called reverse. So this reverse method will take a list, whether it is a list of integers or string. So Suppose we have created a list of integers. So I'll take that list name and then it will reverse our list. Now let's try to print this again. Num start for each, same thing. We'll use the lambda expression to print that. So what I'm trying to do, I'm getting this list again after reverse. Now let's see, if you run this, we see that first there are still 700 is printed, and again after reverse, again the reverse order, 7654321. Okay, so in this way you have the approach to be told to the interviewer. So you can explain other approaches as well. Definitely he'll ask multiple approaches. So first you can give this, again if you ask for different approaches, you can explain whatever I have explained you earlier. So if we see the implementation for this, you have the implementation as well. If you want to go through that, if you want to understand how it has been implemented, you can do that, and it will be very helpful for you to know the internal implementation as well. So that's it in this video. If you are new to this channel, subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon so that you don't miss the latest updates. Thanks for watching this video, and bye bye.